Today's story is Two Little Boys, Ten Big Plagues, written by Carol Craven Bates and illustrated by Jan Church Hopkins. If you would like a copy of this book, there's a link for it in the description. Chapter 11. It was past midnight, but still dark when cries were heard all over Egypt. There was not a single house in all of Egypt where there wasn't at least one dead. Weeping could be heard in every dwelling from the home of Pharaoh to the homes of the servants. Even the prisoners in the dungeons were not spared. The firstborn of the cattle were slain as well. All of Egypt was awake and stirring around. Mr. Pariah suddenly became afraid of what Pharaoh might do to them if he found out where his family had spent the night. He stood and announced that it was time for them to leave. Before the Pariah family left his home, Mr. Grossman spoke privately with his guest. "Ramar, bring your family back here and stay in this house after we're gone. It will be much more comfortable than living in the stable. At least live here until you get the repairs done to your place." Mr. Pariah hugged his dear friend. "You know, I think I'll take you up on that offer. As soon as the shock wears off, everyone will want property in Goshen. Egypt is pretty much destroyed. Besides, living in this house will remind me and my family what good people lived here before us." Mr. and Mrs. Pariah had tears of gratitude flowing from their eyes as they hugged their friends and said goodbye. Jalon and Mecho were tearful as well. They knew they would never see each other again, but at least everyone was safe. At the palace, Pharaoh was so distraught his servants were afraid to enter his presence. They came trembling when they were summoned. One of the servants was hastily dispatched to Goshen with orders to bring Moses and Aaron back to the palace as quickly as possible. Everyone in the land of Goshen was ready to leave Egypt for good. They were delighted when Pharaoh called Moses and Aaron to the palace. It was so early in the morning, it still seemed like night when Pharaoh gave the order. He commanded Moses, "Take your flocks and your herds as you have said and go." Then, very unexpectedly, Pharaoh added, "Bless me also." The children of Israel were relieved to be on their way out of Egypt. After all those years of captivity, they would not have to spend another day in Egypt. Likewise, the people of Egypt were delighted that the Hebrews would be gone soon. The Egyptians couldn't have them leave fast enough. They gave the Israelites everything they needed and wanted, hoping to get rid of them quickly. It was not just the adults that were soliciting things. The children were boldly asking too. Mr. and Mrs. Grossman told Jalon he had their permission to ask the Egyptians for some items for himself. In no time at all, Jalon had three small feed sacks full of rings, coins, gold nuggets, and marbles. Jalon felt as rich as Pharaoh. He had never had so many treasures in his entire life. While the Israelites were scampering around collecting treasures from the Egyptians, Moses was organizing the procession that would soon leave Egypt. Moses thought the hardest part of the trip to the land of Canaan was getting Pharaoh to let the people go. It did not take very long for him to decide that had been the easy part. Moses had 600,000 men, plus women and children, waiting to be led out of Egypt. They all had their household items, clothes, flocks, and herds ready to take with them. The children of Israel had spent 430 years in Egypt. Now they were leaving, and they were not coming back. Jalon and his family weren't the first in line for the exodus, but their little two-wheeled cart was very near the front. So many things were happening, it was hard for Jalon to keep up with it all. He was raring to get going, and it seemed as if they never would. The procession finally started moving. Moses was out in front, carrying nothing but a cloak and his rod. Aaron and Miriam were further back with a wagon loaded down with supplies. One of the most important things that Moses made sure to take with him as he left Egypt was the bones of Joseph. Joseph had predicted long years before that this day would come to pass. Before he died, Joseph had requested that when the children of Israel left Egypt for the Promised Land, they take his bones with them. As a teenager, Joseph had been taken into Egypt against his will and sold as a slave, but he didn't want his remains to stay there. He wanted his bones to go back to the country where he was born. Joseph desired to be buried in the land of Canaan, next to his family members, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Moses was determined to fulfill that request. Everyone was lined up and anxiously waiting for Moses to give the signal to proceed. Before the group started moving, Mr. Grossman warned Jalon not to wander off. He was to keep his family and their ox cart in sight at all times. Jalon couldn't believe how anxious he was to be leaving Egypt. This was a wonderful new day, the first of a wonderful new life in the land of promise.